Hallelujah.
Amen.
Akawungezi kalero.
This evening.
Yagalo kwate Bible yo.
I want you to get your Bible.
Yagalo bikule mu barua yomtume Paulo.
Open the letter of the Apostle Paul.
Yawandikira Abaroma.
That he wrote to the Romans.
Mukama yebazibwe.
Praise the Lord.
Esura nya.
Chapter 4.
Olunyiriri lwa 19.
And verse 19.
Nga tetunaba kusomayo.
Before we read there.
Gwe bikuloberawo.
Just open and keep that page open. And be quiet.
Mukama yebazibwe.
Praise the Lord.
Mubisera ebifanako bwe biti.
In a time such as this.
Munsi yonna ne mu Uganda.
And the whole Uganda.
Waluo ichigena maso.
There's something that is happening.
Munsi yomoyo.
In the spiritual world.
Ne munsi yombiri.
As well as the physical world.
Munsi yombiri.
In the physical world.
Ebintu bingi bigena maso.
There's a lot that is going on.
This is according to me.
Okusinzira kunze.
I'm sensing coldness in the spirit.
There's a coldness that is taking place. For which you must find a solution. The church of our Lord should never be cold. It must move with warmth. It must be fiery. Because it was born out of fire. But according to what I see,
mpola,
little by little, there's something that is killing
omuliro.
That fire.
Omuliro gwasoka.
The fire, the first fire.
Omuliro gwasoka.
The very first fire.
Gwasokera mu upper room.
Started in the upper room.
Mu kisenge kya waguru.
In the upper room.
Abakiriza bali 12.
There were 120 believers.
Naye omuliro negulabika.
But then the fire showed up.
Omuliro ogwo.
That fire.
Gwagenda gwali gwamanyi nnyo.
It was so strong.
Weyongera nnyo.
It increased so much.
Era omuliro ogwo.
And that fire.
Gwatuuka ekiseera.
Time came.
Ne guletera revival gy'otalowooza nti okubaawo.
It brought forth a revival that you had never imagined to happen.
Nti abantu abali ba cowards.
Such that even people who are cowards.
Bafuuka bold.
They became bold.
The Bible says that they preached Christ with boldness. Many things happened. Miracles, signs, wonders happened in the first church. There was a lot of fire. Persecution arose. But the church grew stronger and stronger every day.
Ekanisa neyeyongera okubanti eyongera okukula manyi nenywera buli lunaku.
Amen.
Amen.
The people like Philip.
Abantu nga Filipo.
Became great.
Bafuka bamanyi nyo.
In the first church.
Mukanisa yaso.
People like Peter.
Abantu nga Petero.
Who denied the Lord.
Abegana mukama wafe.
Became stronger.
Ateba damu nyama.
And became a very powerful Peter. Because of the fire of Pentecost. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Many things happened in the first church. There was a lot of persecution. But persecution took the church to another level. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Now, that very fire started
gwatandika
okuka wansi.
Started cooling and reducing.
Neguka.
And it reduced.
Negukira ddala.
And it reduced completely.
Neyecho chaliwo olw'ensonga nyingi.
But this happened for so many reasons.
Ikanisa bo yagenda ngegena mu Gentile world.
When the church went out to the Gentile world.
Era waliwo ebisomoza bingi.
Of course, there were so many challenges.
Okusinga bo yali mu ba Hebrews.
More than it was when it they were still in the Hebrews.
Naye abasajja nga Paul baalwana nnyo.
But men like Paul, they really fought hard.
Baalwana nnyo, baasomesa nnyo.
They really fought and taught so much.
Era Paul Mukama yamulonda nga akimanyi.
And God chose Paul because he knew it.
He was a great teacher.
Yali musomesa w'amaanyi nnyo.
He taught.
Yasomesa.
He was greatly anointed.
Ate yali kamafuta manji.
And caused the revival in the Gentile world.
N'aleta revival mu nsi ene eya
abatali. God used him mightily.
Katonda yamukozesa nnyo.
Mightily.
Mu ngeri y'amaanyi.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Now, that fire continued.
Omuliro gone gweyongera.
We thank God after many years.
Tubaza Katonda oluvema lw'emyaka mingi.
It reached Africa.
Negutuka mu Africa.
And we thank God. Even in our generation, the fire is still on. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Now,
kakati.
Omuliro gugenda gugwagena nga gukane kudamu ne kuvumbuja.
The fire would reduce and then it would light up again.
Walu akatabo keba furumia ndoza mu 2015.
There was a book that was published in 2015.
Akali kogera ku revival.
That was talking about kuzivuja.
Nibogera ku batsajja ba approach vebulaya.
They talked about men like the approach vebulaya.
Nabantu abenja ulo abadde ba heading revivals.
And the different people who are heading revivals.
Yaba Pentecoste.
The revivals of the Pentecostals.
Akataba ako.
Now that book.
Nakagula na yesimanje nakamisplacing era.
I bought it but I don't know why I misplaced it.
Naye.
However.
Akataba ako.
That book.
Kalago omuliro je kuvudde.
Shows the history of the fire.
Mu myaka ndoze ya 5.
From the years of the 80s.
Eh.
50s.
Vudde. Mukama afe bazibu.
Praise the Lord.
Onetaka ko kuteka ke bigere. Mu myaka ja 5.
In the years of the 50s.
Neyingira nkaga.
And it went into the 60s.
Neyingira 7.
It went into the 70s.
Wanawafe mu Uganda.
Here in Uganda.
Awidi Amin nayagala okuzikiza omuliro.
Idi Amin wanted to put out the fire.
Katonda nagolokoka.
And God rose up.
Neguddamu.
And it was ignited a much later.
Nokutusolwa lero.
Up to today.
Naye mukusinzira ku kyenda bane history kwemba densoma.
But according to what I'm saying and the history I've been reading about.
Omuliro.
The fire.
Gula bika kugenda kukamuna kuzino.
It is reducing in these days.
Chempito omuliro okuka.
What I refer to the reducing of the fire.
Siwe butalokoka.
Is not that people are not getting saved.
Abantu balokoka gwe.
People are getting saved.
Banji nyo.
In big numbers.
Okusinzira edda.
According to the past.
Era amakanisa manji mbitundu nego nagajuza agabalokole.
Many born again churches there are many born again churches in the communities but all of them get full up.
Naye.
However.
Munda makanisa mbantu abalokose.
Inside the churches among the people who are born again.
Waluwe chiriwo.
There is something happening.
Ere chiriwe chechokuola.
And what is happening, I mean the coldness.
Kireteddwa
has been brought about
okubeera nga amakanisa agamu tegafunye teaching emala
by the fact that some churches have not received ample teaching.
Bible says continue in my word.
Bible gamu yongere mu kigambo
cyo. You know the truth and the truth will set us free.
Muna manya mazima na mazima gana bafula bedembe.
Njagala ogende mpola ngo mpuliriza.
Keep following.
Ojja kunfuna.
And you'll understand me.
I
send greetings to those who are dozing. You're doing a good job. But I'll give you a hot slap. Praise the Lord. Now, in these days, besides teaching, you know, when a person is ignorant,
Satan
loves those people so much.
Omukatonda yetakola nabatamanyi.
God does not work with the ignorant.
Era Bible ganti abantu bange bazikiridde.
And the Bible says my people perish.
Olwokubulwa okumanya.
Because they lack knowledge.
Okumanya manyi.
Knowledge is power.
Zero nabulide bangirikani mfutte. Teri agamba amina.
Please say amen.
Oh. Nza kwentudde ne muloza anti.
I think because I was seated.
Simanyi kuyimirira.
I don't know how to stand.
Yesu yebaziwe.
Praise Jesus.
Eyamina zetenkolera. Yesu yebaziwe.
Praise Jesus.
Simanyi ngambe ntya. Yesu yebaziwe. Kale. Okusomesa kuno.
This teaching.
Kuyamba kubanga okumanya amaanyi.
Helps because knowledge is power.
Amaanyi.
And power.
Aga kuyamba okuwangula.
The power that helps you to become victorious.
Mu research yange.
According to my research.
Okubeddala mu 2005.
From the day of
2005.
Up to this year where we are now.
Wabaddewo obuzibu.
There was a problem.
Ky'okusomesa kubadde kutono.
That there was so little teaching.
Kutya.
How is that?
Engeri abantu gye basobola okwangangamu ebizibu.
Can attack challenges.
Ebizibu ebisinze okugenda nga biwoza abantu.
It is the problems that have called people, that have made people to call.
Ebisomoza.
The challenges.
Bigenda bizikiza omuliro.
They are putting out the fire slowly.
So nga waliwo obwetaavu.
So there is a need.
Obw'abasumba.
For the pastors.
Okusomesa abantu.
To teach the people.
N'okubabuulira.
As well as to tell them.
Singa oba ofunye ekisomoza.
But if you ever encounter a challenge.
Ng'oli mulokole.
And you're born again.
Okola bw'oti.
This is what you must do.
Kutandika mu 2002.
Now starting from the years 2000. There's something that entered into Uganda.
Waliwo omulembo gwa bubanka bubaita microfinance bank.
There is that era of the microfinance banks.
Bwajjanga mu byalo.
It used to move to the villages, to the community.
Waffe tulina mu kitundu kya Kasangati waliyo bubanka ki.
What are those banks that existed in Kasangati? It is just current.
Huh? Pride is a joke.
I'm talking about 2005. Women, you're well versed with these things.
Huh? Annie? You got for the J. What way is that? Annie?
Jesus.
Think of Uganda and here, Joe.
They are those first ones that came Buganda to
Busoga.
Especially in Buganda and Busoga. They were telling people, you need to team up in groups of 5-5. So we can give you money. You could give in something smaller, security. Give your land agreement, or you'd rather you plot your house.
Mpola mpola.
So little by little.
Abantu niba yingira mu ekintu.
You know that spirit was into people of borrowing.
Ne kibangu iza nyo bulamu.
And it really covered.
Abalokole na abatali balokole.
The lives of both born again and those who are not born again.
Na ye byabanga mu bintu ebyo.
However, what results?
Byabanga maziga.
It was always tears.
Kubanga bibanja byabantu byagenda.
Because people lost their plots.
Amayumba gagenda.
People lost their houses.
Bamekanga nyumba ye yagenda.
How many of you lost your house?
Ekinyumba ya tata unga yagenda kale.
If your father lost his house.
Yajja unga bajitwala.
If your granny's house was
kibanja nga bajitwala.
If the plot was taken.
Bagirabiranga unga banyondo baze.
You know, you just see those things
coming.
Because you failed to pay up your loan. And things started happening like
ani
that.
Agama,
who says what I'm talking about? Is a reality. I just think about it. Thank you for giving me your support. So that mindset.
Mbantu,
once it entered into people's
minds.
People would say, I'm going to go and attain capital.
Nkole.
So that I can work. And in need, working is needful.
Kati, niwaba uomulabe woya ingirida.
But there is somewhere where the enemy entered.
Basebo nebanyabu.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Sent si chintu changu.
Money is not an easy thing.
Okuchuwa omuntu ngabadde tali used.
Giving it to someone that was not used.
Na chikumo kumala omwaka.
And they managed to keep it for a full year.
Eranjagalo okirize obogane.
Believe it or not.
Bible bwegamba nti bw'oba omwesigwa mu kitono bali kusigira ebingi.
When the Bible says that if you're faithful with a little, you'll be given much.
Erino kyetegeeza.
It means something.
Bw'obanga olina emitwalo ataano.
If you have 500,000,
no soko igo koze semi tuaratano,
and you first learn how to utilize that 500,000,
no chijamwe chama gezi,
and you're able to get something sensible out
we
of it.
Bakuwa million yetano,
once you are given 5 million,
oboso bolozi jamwe chama gezi,
then you can very well get something sensible out of it as well.
Nchiita chabulabe.
I call it dangerous. To give somebody a lot of money, yet they were not used or accustomed to
it.
Today, you can tell someone that I'm giving you 20 million. If someone was not accustomed to using millions, first of all, they buy the gomasi, the chitambala, and that. Because they feel like the money is too much.
They first use
to take their children back in school, and yet that's a loan money. They even they make a party and invite
them.
By the time they wake up, it has started to really we can very well invest it and we get
profit.
But before you know it, what they thought it was is not what it is. What causes that?
It's
by the fact that you were not used.
Uganda,
brethren, listen to me. God has never been wrong. By first entrusting us with
it,
we get used to the
little.
Because it's taking us
to the little.
He's taking us very far. There are certain people who say,
Lord,
why have you kept me at this level?
The Lord is training you.
If you're faithful with the little, then you're able to even receive much. Some of you have not clapped to them. Please give me my 1 billion, you say. You think 1 billion is so much, but it's little. It depends on the generation where it is. Long time ago, a billion shillings was so big. But lately, billions.
Babu Gabamu district. You know, their district budget yayo obuumbi ana.
They say this district is going to
have a billion.
But now when you look at it, according to a generation, when you look at the cost of
assets,
a billion is something little. There's something I want to tell you. When you fail to manage
this,
then you can hardly manage that. If I could get capital, my business will just prosper greatly. But I'm telling it's a lie. If you cannot manage 500,000 and you save
something,
and you pay for your rent, and you maintain your
capital,
then you will not even be able to manage 500 million. If you don't agree on that point, I'll stop that message here. Who says I am right in that? You've had these experiences and you know it. God may live into a situation because he wishes that if you are one person to learn to manage 15,000 when you are alone, you buy a piece of soap, you buy some matoki. I mean 15,000 when you're
home.
You can buy a raw piece of chicken. You buy 2 onions. And you buy 2 tomatoes. As well as
training.
But God is training. So that you'll be happy with the little that you have. And when a visitor finds
you,
when you have chicken and matoke on your plate, these people have made it.
Omutwalo
that 15,000 is what you use to get
peace.
To get peace.
Yeah,
there's someone who can get it and feels that it's not enough.
okusukulume nyingizayo.
So they begin to spend over and above.
Eriaba fanana bwebatyo.
There are people who are like that.
Nenga Katonda akuleseewo mumbere.
God has left in that.
Oyigokoze sebitono.
So you can.
Alioka kusigira ebingi.
So that he can give you much.
Living beyond your means is a sign of pride. Yes. Because the time comes and you learn and you begin to compete. You want to jump steps. You want to be like her. You want to put on like her. That is a sign of pride. Before God lifts somebody, God humbles that person. Before God takes you up, He puts you down. Before Jesus rose up, before He went, before He ascended, before the ascension, praise the Lord.
Amen.
Before the ascension, He first went down to hell and preached. Amen.
Amen.
What does that mean? Before you go up, you first go down. Before you go up, you first go down. That law will never change.
Has a man deluded?
That law will never change. God resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Before God lifts you, He first combats pride. He takes pride out of you.
How? By humbling you.
Bible
gamba. The Bible says, I took you to the and I humbled you. Because I wanted to teach you. That man does not live alone. But by each and every word that proceeded from the mouth of God. Some of you think God has
protected
you. But no, He hasn't.
He's just humbling you. He's squeezing pride out of you.
Brethren who are over there, you know. Every time a parent fails to manage their child, do you know what happens? The government is always watching. They take the child
from the state.
And they say the child belongs to the state.
So,
as a parent, if you fail to take your
child,
as a parent, if your child
what was state you,
there's a state that's watching
the state
over
of you. Heaven.
A state ye guru.
Any time is going to take over. God can take over your home. God can take over the responsibility of your family. Just
say
what
they
tokola.
Even though you're not
working.
You have matoke in the corner.
What they tokola.
God brings a circle. Because God
can take
over. When you fail,
He takes over. He can teach your children. God can educate your children. God can keep you without the soldiers. God can keep your family. The Bible says the Lord will preserve you. Will preserve you. Say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, bobero butono.
So if you're young,
bobango line bitono.
If you have little,
run,
don't first regret and
feel bad.
Because he's the God of
blessings.
But he's trying to teach you something. He would like to teach
you
how to value that one cloth that you
have.
You have that one
cloth.
You wear it during
the night.
And you wash it at
night.
Not because he doesn't have clothes. But because he wants to teach you. That when he gives you
the
clothes, you remember the needy.
No, so sobola basigamu.
And you'll be able to bless them.
Mukama afe bwe yajja munsi.
When our Lord came to this world.
Walochi yajja okulokola.
There's something he came to do. He came to save.
Yajja okulokola.
He came to save.
Ne yajja n'okustudy embeera z'abantu.
But he came to study the situation of the
human. Tuyitamu yakiyitamu.
He has ever experienced whatever we are going through.
Bamuvumako.
He was once abused. He was once rejected. He was hated. He was once mocked. Whatever we go through, he went through. He was once robbed. Judah robbed him. So there's nothing that you go through that he never went. He went through it once. So that he can understand the pain. Said that when you pray to him, he will understand what you mean. Something that you're going through today.
You were a single mother.
Only single man.
You are an orphan.
Only
you are an orphan. The time will come. God will take out that situation. God will give you all the wealth you need.
But
after reaching there, God expects you to help other orphans. Because you are
once an orphan as well. Amen.
God is training you to use the little. God is training someone. What you are passing through, God is teaching you.
The longer you take to learn,
class
is the more you keep repeating that same class. He's not making you suffer, but he's simply teaching you. Why is he teaching you? Because you're going to leave that state and go into victory. So you can remember those who are going through the same. If you are once having one cloth to put on, when you have plenty of
clothes,
when they ask, we want to
soak
clothes, you can
nange nali sirina.
Once I also never had. Amen. If a person has ever had a
experience,
they are witness. Amen. If you have ever had a child, or if you have ever been despised by your
husband,
if you overcome that challenge, that situation, when you talk to a fellow man who's been through it, the pain will come back. And you try to find a way to help them. Because you also once went through the same
situation.
The situation you're going through, you're going through it to learn. In certain
schools,
when they discover a wise child, they don't even complete the 3 terms. They move from one stream to another. And then they say, let's put them in a stream. Because it means that they'll also some even get accelerated
promotion.
So when you
learn,
you leave
that
and you go to the next. I'm here to inform you that there's a class that you fail to learn, and that is the one of living by faith.
The Bible says that just shall live by faith. Instead of people living by faith, they got an alternative of borrowing from those banks, the financial, whatever I've told you, the microfinance. And later, people started getting other ways of borrowing. The people like moneylenders started coming up. From 2009 to 2008,
the moneylenders started.
They
started popping. And they were lending people money.
No ulilanga, ba ulanga, ba tuala tampeko zaba antu.
That they land and they take people's.
Baso ka tuala tampeko nevi domora.
Cups and jerrycans in the beginning.
Echaba mne bagena, kaba tuali bintu ntuwe bidala.
They started taking other items.
Abantu baso kaba funaya mageza amadala.
And people found other ways.
Agokole bibina.
Of making those groups.
Ebiokuwa.
Those circles.
Gwe, nero gofuna.
Those cash pools today, the one is, and the next day is the other one. That's even where some wise women would go and join. And they would also make them cry. Amen. So we left that stage. Now at this point, if you're taking your child back to school, what you have is what will save you. So they go to the money lender.
TV yang.
I have my TV set.
Mpa fees.
Give me school TV. Fees and I'll give you the TV. So the TV is taken.
Intebe.
The set of chairs. They come and take them also. Until we completely and we go to the wall. Now we started going to the pastors.
Walinga alternative yokwewola.
Previously, when the alternative to
sumba.
There's no way you could come to the
pastors.
You feel like what you have can save you. You can give your
fees.
In exchange for you can give that
item.
I want to inform you that God is not at all happy with that system. Is the same system that Pharaoh who lived in the days of Moses used. Amen.
People are not living by faith. Because there was no food. Those 7 years. There was no food.
So what was there? Every time they needed food.
Yusuf.
They would call upon Joseph.
Yusuf.
Say Joseph.
Wanji.
Yes, please.
We are
lacking food. What can you give me in exchange?
We
are giving you our land. They kept giving their
cattle.
They gave this. Until everything was
finished.
And they had nothing to offer.
Mugani. What
I'm saying is that
it
until they had nothing left once it was all finished, they became slaves to Pharaoh. But they used to give everything in exchange for
food.
They would eat it and eat it and
eat it.
And then they would increase.
Again.
Once it was over, they would give what
Muganda they had.
So my sister brother
and
can go back to school without giving or selling your land. Now, Pastor, where will the money come from? Surrender to God and you'll see.
His ways are not our ways. Most
parents who had huge
children,
when they were born again,
amataka ge gasomeseza abaana.
It is their land that has taught their children.
Batuka mu retirement age.
So they go to the retirement age.
Batubalina we balimira wadde
rumonde. And they had no land to plant even potatoes.
Lwaki?
Why?
Babadde basomesa abaana.
Because they were educating their children.
Kati nze musumba nkole ntya.
Pastor, what can I do?
Anti awenzija.
Now this is where I'm driving to.
Chichi cholino kola.
What have you got to do?
Imbira ngefuse bwetu.
When the situation gets like that.
Chichi cholino kola.
What must you do?
The Bible says.
Bible yegamba.
The just shall live by faith. And what is faith? How does it come? Faith comes by hearing. If you have a situation, if you have a challenge in life, and that challenge wants to eat you up, you run to God because He is our refuge and strength. You run to God before you borrow. Before you borrow, run to God. Go to God. What God tells you is the beginning of your miracle.
Anji. Amen.
Run to God.
Dukira ewaka
tonda. Don't go to many lenders.
Todukira mbamani.
Run to God.
Dukira ewaka tonda.
He will make a way where it seems to be no way.
Awala bikanga watali kubo.
This is what Moses used to do.
Kino Musa cheyakola.
Whenever challenges approached his congregation,
the people
would run to Moses.
And
then Moses ran to God. What God used to tell Moses was the answer for the congregation.
But we have not done that. We only know one thing. What you have is what can save you. And God says it is well. Use it all and let it save
you.
It's all used up and there's nothing.
Now you are crying, oh Lord. We are perishing. We are perishing. I wish you cried like that. I wish you cried like that. Before.
Walia mabega.
The church is in trouble. I
mean,
the body of Christ is in trouble. We've not told people to walk by faith. To live by faith. If you get a challenge and you have your land somewhere, when you come to pastors, you tell pastor, I want to sell my land. I want to sell my house. It is not a bad idea. But if you sell it today, well and good, you will solve that problem. But is it the end of you? Are you going to die tomorrow? What if you sell all the property you have?
Singa otunda byonna byonna byonna.
And then challenges keep on coming.
Ate nebisomoza
nebyoyongera okujja. Ologenda kuzzaako ki? You have nothing to offer.
Tochalina byakuwaayo.
Tolirawo musingo.
You don't have any security.
Ngambo lwalero.
So today I'm saying,
Katonda tuyambe.
May God help us.
Muntunulire mwenna.
All of you look at me. Someone is looking down.
Nede eriiso libukemu likwe manyangwa. Mukama
febazibwe. Praise the Lord.
Bwobanga tolina kyolina.
If you have nothing to offer,
osobola okubaako kyofuna mu Katonda.
You can receive something from God.
Bwobanga tolina fees.
If you don't have school fees,
nga olina n'omusingo.
And you also have security.
Nsuubira okujja kugamba Mukama yagambye nti singayo ekintu ekyofuna fees.
I believe that unless it is God who guides you, that you should give it a security to get school fees. Please never give it as security. Go to God and let Him make a way for you. There are people who are educated. And they don't have parents. And they don't have anything to give as security. They don't have anything to give
as security.
But God paves the way.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Waliwo abantu.
There are some people.
Abayita bulamu buno.
Who go through this.
Nga tebalina musingo.
Without any collateral.
Naye ne babeera nga baliwo mu bulamu obuli successful.
But still they live a successful.
Lwaki?
Why does that happen?
Misingo bajja bagwako.
Because they have no collateral or security.
Ne bayimusa amasoka bali nga tunuulira Yesu.
So they raise up their eyes to look at Jesus.
Bible egamba mutunuulire nze mu amawanga gonna mulokolebwe.
Bible says, look at me all ye nations. Mutunuulire
nze mu amawanga gonna mulokolebwe mabanja.
All ye nations and you'll be saved.
Mutunuulire nze.
Look up
mu amawanga gonna mulokolebwe.
That you may be saved.
Ate bogenda mu nchiri.
And when you go
manya mu baluwe emu.
Or to one episode.
Egamba, looking unto Jesus. The author and the finisher of our faith.
Okukiriza kwa fe.
Put your eyes on Jesus.
Teka amaso go ku Yesu.
Put your eyes on the Lord.
Amaso go gateke ku mukama.
Not your husband.
So si kumwami wo.
Yes, not your husband.
Togateka kumwami wo.
Because he's a human like you.
Kubanga naye muntu buntu nga
gwe. Not your parents.
Si kubazadde bo.
Today.
Olwaleero.
People are crying.
Abantu bakaba.
People have lost everything.
Abantu bafiriddwa buli kimu.
Why?
Lwaki?
Because there is no faith.
Kubanga tewali kukkiriza.
There is no faith.
Tewali kukiriza.
Nze nkubulire.
I'm telling you.
Mubiri kumi nebiri.
2012.
Abantu abakiriza bali balinayo kobuntu bwabo obutono.
Some believers had some assets.
Nayama banja gabutwala.
But they lost it all due to debt.
Lwachi.
Why is that?
Okutegwali bulamu bwakukiriza.
They were not living a life of faith.
Okukiriza osoka wa Katonda.
If you have faith, you always resort to God.
Kyakugamba.
And whatever God tells you.
Chechizalo okukiriza.
Is what births our faith.
Faith comes by.
Okukiriza.
What have you heard?
Kachouli dechi.
Ogena chouli rotianga tu sosi wa Katonda.
How then will you hear it if you've not gone to God first?
Praise the Lord.
Amen. If getting out of the situation needs you to first sell your belongings, then you're in great trouble. Because the time will come and you no longer have anything left to sell. But the challenges will never stop. So will you end up selling
it?
You can take me
in
the days of Elisha. There's a woman whose children are going to be taken from her. Elisha, by the time he came, her children were all going to be
taken
because their father had died. All her children were about to be taken because of debts. Elisha saved her.
If you're in debt, you need the prophetic to touch to save you.
Wetaga ekisacho bunabbi chikutase.
You need the prophetic.
Wetaga ekirabo
chikutase. The prophetic grace.
Ekisacho bunabbi.
Is going to help our decade.
Chechigendo okuyamba ekyasa kino obo omulembe guno.
Our decade is going to be helped by the prophetic. Because it
is all already put to waste. Everything is just in turmoil. They had taken everything. The woman had nothing to give. Now all she had were her children. And when she was just about to offer, they were
going
to be sold off as slaves. The prophetic grace came. And it did supernatural things. What do you have in your house?
Of oil.
That's bring that oil, he said. Bring those containers,
Benzins,
jerrycans. They brought all of them. Said, don't start pouring it. And when she poured it, it got
full.
Said, keep pouring. They brought everything possible in
container.
Once all the containers
came, he asked all the containers full.
Said, I no longer have it. I even kept some in the spoons. And then it went dry.
It takes the prophetic to pay the debts. That is the testimony you always hear. What Sarah Mujabi gives.
She came before me. When the prophetic grace was upon me, I looked at her. My house is going to be taken.
And
I told her, please go back home.
Later, akakekako.
Bring your
mind.
Lay down over there. Common sense could not
accept.
But how did that
come?
She came and slept. She didn't even
know.
That was the beginning of her journey. The anointing started to
pour out.
Until when she cleared 250 million shillings.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
When the
situation
you need the prophetic.
Franka
huyo yajanga namba amabanja ga million
bisatu. But he cannot explain to you
buli kasere million bisatu engejeza gwayo.
How he was able to clear the
debt.
But he indeed cleared it.
Natukachera ngaziweddeyo.
The time came when he had cleared his debt.
Nazima theater ya million bitano.
He constructed a theater
because of the prophetic.
Courage such a would not be. But when your life is in turmoil,
we need the prophetic to take over.
That
man, God had lifted him. He traveled the nations. He even reached the White House. That man, he traveled the many states of
America.
But the devil doesn't love good things. Started pulling him down. All
the way to the ground.
Amen.
Amen.
Eventually
he came here
and
he surrendered his life to Jesus
and
he came in counseling
and he
showed me and said,
Pastor,
please, I would like this word to come back into my
life. But
I told him some of them will not
come back.
However, some will come
back.
And then I mentioned and
said,
but there's someone who looks like this
and that.
That person will come into your
life
and they will greatly transform your
life.
Now that is the one who brought forth the theater.
When
the woman was about to
sell her children,
when everything had completely
finished, the prophetic saved the
situation.
The prophet saved the situation. Let me tell you, the devil has stolen everything from us because we are not walking by faith. When challenges come, financial challenges come, the devil begins to tell you,
what you have is what
will
save you. Your chair is taken, and yet you make it past
that time.
Your bed is
open,
also make it
past that time.
Once God
sees it,
aside and says, move like
that.
Once you're
tired,
when you get to the
world,
you'll come to
me.
You have lost
no so many things.
To the extent that you have nothing left
to say
until you lift up your
eyes. Now I know
that
my Redeemer lives.
I know
it's only Jesus who can save
me. You
are my Savior.
You
start looking at Jesus, the author and the finisher, the author and the finisher, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I wish we do it before
things get bad.
The Lord spoke to me this morning that I want my people to go back and walk by faith. Unless they walk by faith.
Many bad situations are continuing to come. Many bad situations
are continuing to come.
God told me that some years back, like
4 or 5,
he told me bad situations are continuing to come. But they shouldn't bother you. I thought
God was going to worry.
Problems are
coming,
but they don't concern
because you have a Savior.
Many are the challenges of the righteous person. But God saves him out of them all. God will save you out of each and everything.
Begin by now. Walking by faith. Living by faith. Going to school by faith. Educating your children by faith. Believing for marriage by faith. But how are you going to do it? Romans 4:19.
And not being weak in faith, he did not consider his own body already dead since she was about to be 100 years old, and the deadness of Sarah's womb. He did not waver at the promise of God through unbelief, but was strengthened in faith, giving glory to God.
Praise the Lord. Read Amen. In Luganda.
Amen.
Brethren,
Abuluganda,
we want to be like Abraham.
Chagala kubedanga Ibrahim.
Nsaba Ibrahim azukirire mu bulamu.
I pray that Abraham will be resurrected through your life.
Yabikola cha Ibrahim.
How did Abraham manage to do it?
Many times when I'm preaching, I make this statement.
Ntera okola statement
yenu. That Abraham,
nti Ibrahim,
did not consider his contradictory circumstances. Let me tell you the reason why things are getting bad. Many people are not taught what faith is and how it comes. Let me first teach you. Faith comes by hearing. Hearing who? God.
Ngoulira Katonda.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Before God speaks,
Katonda bwabata naba kuogera.
There is no faith.
Tewaba kukiriza.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Before God speaks,
Katonda bwabata nayogera.
There is no faith.
Tewaba kukiriza.
If we go back,
butuddayo.
Okutusanga abasumba bategedde, or they can access into the presence.
Until the pastors have understood, obanga basobola okuyingira mu kubeera okwo.
To hear from God,
okusobola okuwulira
okuva mu Katonda, will not be birthed.
Tekulizaalibwa.
And if faith is not birthed,
ate okukkiriza okuba tekuzaaliddwa,
we are in trouble.
Tuli mu bizibu.
God will never talk,
Katonda taliyogera,
until you come closer to him.
Okutuusanga ozze n'osembera okumpi waali.
Amen.
Amen.
If God comes,
kati Katonda bw'ajja
in the church,
mu kanisa,
he will talk.
Ajja kwogera.
Whatever God talks,
ate buli Katonda ky'ayogera,
he talks faith.
Ayogera kukkiriza.
The word of God carries many things.
Ekigambo kya Katonda kijja kirina
ebintu bingi. The word of God carries creative power.
Ekigambo kya Katonda kyeti kamanya amatonzi.
Carries faith.
Kyeti kokukkiriza.
Carries anointing.
Kyeti kamafuta.
And many things.
N'ebirala bingi.
When God speaks,
Katonda bw'ayogera,
that I've healed you,
n'agamba nkuwonyezza,
I've healed you,
nkuwonyezza,
that's the foundation of your faith.
Ogwo gwe musingi gw'okukkiriza kwo.
Now, in each blessing, there is a God one side and a man one side. When God says, Nuru, I've given you this, now you do your part. What is your part? To accept. How do you accept it? With your heart. You believe with your heart. Brethren, it is hard. Sometimes you see people clapping, but inside they have questions. How will that be? Bw'olemererwa oku accepting ky'owulidde.
If you fail to accept what you have heard,
faith will never be birthed.
Kati okukkiriza tekulizaalibwa.
Kitandikiddewa.
Where did it start?
You to come closer.
Gwe ng'ojja kumpi osembera.
To come where God is.
Ojjawo Katonda waali.
Ntegeera ntya Katonda waali.
How do I know where God is?
Katonda.
God.
Omusanga wakugambye.
Can only be found where he has directed you or told you.
Ogani.
Amen.
Ameka basibi.
How many of you are fasting today?
I'm fasting,
but I speak and I
just pray.
But the rest of you, I don't know, maybe you're too full.
Amen.
Amen.
Katondo musangawa.
Where do you find God?
Katondo musangawa gambinti genda.
God, where he has told you that now
go. Genda wo yakusoka
wo. There he goes ahead of you.
Olwalera abantu bawulira Katonda.
Today people don't hear God.
Kubanga tebagendanga ko Katonda wabagambye genda.
They've never gone where God has told them to go.
Yona yalowoza.
Jonah thought.
Ndibali abantu bali stubborn.
That those who are just
Abe
stubborn.
Nineve.
People of Nineveh were stubborn. God must be
disturbed.
He's instructing me to
those are stubborn people, they are sinners. They can't listen to me. Their hearts are stony. Let me go to the other city. That is disobedience. He disobeyed. When he disobeyed, the whale swallowed him. When he repented, the whale vomited him where God had directed him to go. When he reached there, he was amazed to see that God had already reached there, had already transplanted the hearts, the stony hearts. The moment he spoke, people started repenting. People started repenting. And he said, oh my God.
God had gotten there before him. When God tells you go to London, he goes ahead of you. When God tells you go to
Nabugabo,
and you go to Nabugabo,
you've missed God.
You've missed God.
Mukama bagamba nti gende kasanga.
When God tells you
no gende kansanga.
You go to kansanga.
Katondo ba mulemi.
Then you have missed God.
Togenda mbulira.
You'll never hear him.
Manji. Mukama bagamba nti gende mawule.
When God tells you
no gende chiware.
And you go to chiware.
Katondo ba mumisinze.
You have missed out on God.
Manji.
Amen.
Mama, tunulinde gandona, ulira bichi.
She's looking at me and wondering what
I'm doing. Nkukubira ka jam.
I've also given you a
Sikumanyi Neema.
I don't know you are, but
aba Pentecostals be wuja.
The Pentecostals are
hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Katonda tumumisinze.
We have missed out on God.
If you miss God, you miss his voice.
Bo missing ane dobozi li.
When you miss his voice,
bo missing e dobozi li.
You miss faith.
Obo missinze okukiriza.
What the devil does, the devil misplaces us. Because he knows the moment you go the other side, when God is the other side, you will never get the voice of God. And if you don't have the voice of God, there is no faith. And if there is no faith, you will fail from January to December. The just shall live by faith. The just shall live by faith. Faith comes by hearing.
It is not because God doesn't
know.
But people are very far. God is calling you to be a pastor, but
for evangelist.
You become an evangelist.
God calls
you to be an artist or singer, you start a church. God calls you to start a church.
To put it in kansanga.
And you put it in kansanga instead.
Mukama nagamba gende mbale.
God tells you go to mbale.
No gende kabale.
And you go to kabale.
Yoli.
Are you there?
You miss God.
O missinga katonda.
You miss God.
No suba katonda.
You miss the voice of God.
No missinga dobozi lya katonda.
You end up struggling.
Omalirizo ofuba ofuba.
Are you in the right place?
Oli mu kifo ekituufu.
Kiki ekikakasa nti ni mu kifo kituufu?
What confirmation shows that I'm
an open heaven, of course.
Eggulu erigule.
Not only that.
Ate si ekyo kyokka.
If you're in the right place.
Oli wobeera mu kifo ekituufu.
You hear God speaking.
Ne Katonda omuwulira nga ayogera.
You hear God speaking.
Owulira Katonda nga ayogera.
Faith comes by hearing.
Kukkiriza kujja na kuwulira.
Embera joli mukatone yali ayogedde.
The situation you're going through, has God ever
said that?
If God has
ever said
that, then it is going to persist so much longer.
Tulina.
We have.
Abasumba.
Pastors.
Abandi bade basirikare.
Who should be soldiers or in the military?
Yes. Amina.
Amen.
Tulina abasawo.
We have some medical personnel, some nurses.
Abandi bade ba police.
Who should be in the police?
Nolabanga government efiridwa.
The government suffers loss.
Mchala linya katanda.
Climb that bed, woman.
Sinze nakutwala yo.
I'm not the one who sent you there.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Andrew alazewa watu gani?
Where is Andrew?
Mbwe ya manyiyo jabadenga.
They say he's been there and he knows that place.
Sibu watu gambi mama.
Until the one who told us.
Mukama yeba ziwe.
Praise the Lord.
The devil misplaces people.
Stanya changa la nyara.
Sometimes it's because of ignorance.
Chiba oro butamanya.
Iri abantu abali e UK.
There are some people in the UK.
Nabani bade mu America.
But they should be in America.
Iri abali mu America.
Some people.
Nabani bade UK.
But they should be in the UK.
Sitani anga pengalo.
Satan.
Agambo yo pakoro aliva munsi.
Until that.
Ajaku shigananga alingo muntu omulala.
They'll just be like any other
normal. Kubanga ne boba tolina katondo olya oyambala.
Even if you don't have God, you can dress up
and. Ne boba ne katonda.
But if you have.
Obera onge ebiroto byo bwebiri.
You live according to your.
Katonda atukirize ebiroto byo.
God fulfills your dream.
Abantu balinze.
People are waiting.
Ne bafira mu kukiriza.
And they have died in faith.
Ne batabira bako.
And they haven't seen anything.
Ne bafanga babira musa.
They die. I went seeing it at a distance.
Duachi.
Why is that?
They are in wrong places.
Kubanga bali mbifebi cham.
They are not doing what God purposed them to do.
Tebali mukole choka twana cheva tekira tekero kola.
You can be saved.
Osobola okulokolebwa.
But you have to sit where God wants you to sit.
Obo insobola kwango limulokole nayo inokutula okatanda bayagala otule.
Katonda wabayo gera joli.
When God is speaking to you.
Nokukiriza kwanguwa.
Faith is even easy, or believing is easy. How can I know that God is in this place? When you are being
born,
have you ever seen God?
That
Kampala Road, he's in Kampala Road putting on a kanzu. No one has ever seen God with their eyes. But you see God through his work. If you see God at work, just know where your eyes, where he is. Saying that God is walking on foot. God
is
to craft you and also to create for you.
Kutonda no kutondera.
To craft you and also to create for you.
Eya mu kanisa nga tolina sanyu.
You came to church without joy.
Ogenda kulanga ofuna sanyu.
You begin to get joy. You begin to
ogenda kulanga ofuna obugumiinkiriza.
You develop patience.
Eyali ayomba nga nechoyomba tochiddamu.
You was quarrelsome and you.
Eyali avuma.
You'd abuse.
Ng'omuntu ayinza okuvuma.
Person would abuse you. Until you begin to cry.
They
say, now I'm done with you.
Even
if you step on them, they say,
that
God created something different in you.
It is only God. Only God. Who can do that? No one has power to change mankind. It is only God.
There's a way you can tell that there's God in that church. There are certain things that can be staged and others that can't. There are certain things that only God can do. Issues regarding to man. It's only left with God. Even the whites are still failing at it. But a person comes in church. And God heals that illness that the whites fail to treat. Just know that there's God in that place. I've been in Nangaba and I've
heard
their testimonies. And my prayer every day. I break the
cycle
that hinders things from
that
hinders people from speaking the things that God has done for them. But there's God in this place. This gentleman testified.
Jangu brother.
Brother, come yes. Please. He testified recently and I felt. And I said, my goodness. What is this? This gentleman told us that his mom is a pastor. Pastress in a certain church.
But the mom,
her mother's, his mother's friend. told her that the situation of your son, please direct him to go to Kasangat to look for a gentleman called Pastor
Rhema
and let him sit in his church. I want to thank God. How long have you been here?
From March last year, what can we
look at and confirm that God has had an encounter with God? What were you before and what are you right now? Tell us.
Praise
God.
Maurice
is his name.
When I jira wano musumba,
when I came here, Pastor, all my businesses had failed.
So, because that challenge had gone on for more than 18 months.
Challenge, yali erudde onge maze emyezi 18.
Naye bwenajja wano waliwo ekintu kye nalaba ekyenjawulo.
When I came here, I noticed there was something different.
That the first Friday of the overnight.
Friday, so okay, overnight.
Sumba, after the prayers, I remember waita Elder Julie, noita Dr. Kaigwa.
You called Kaiga, Dr. Kaiga.
Ne Professor, ne
and
Isaac.
Professor Bale and Isaac.
Kati, the more they spoke about their lives, they had one specific word that I noticed. Ngabagamba, Pastor spoke this into my life.
And they kept saying, Mtimusumba, yayogere chigambo mubulambwa.
Ngabagamba, chinewichi into, oh, I started this way. Level, but Pastor has been, like Elder Julie was always saying that,
I think
a marketing executive. By the time she gave that testimony, she had gone to the top four. It was the same story with Elder Bale.
Isaac
and Dr. Kaiga.
So
for me, because I was just seated there and I've always wanted myself to be under that anointing that has a significant voice, like Kati, when I heard that, I said, if this pastor, if it's the same person who has spoken to all these
people,
then I need to wait and wait for him and wait for my wife. So I kept waiting for so many months, but it was about 5 months. Then I came and talked to you. And when I met you, you told me, do this and this and this, but keep waiting until the Lord.
So
in a nutshell, this year, I was seated over there. And Mr. Wogere was seated in their spot. I remember specifically you calling me.
When you called him out, wamubuza nti oyinamu emitwalo abiri.
So nakkiriza n'omugamba, I want you to send this 200,000.
He accepted and you told him, njagala emitwalo agabiri ogambira omuvubuka oyo.
So when he did that and you asked me, he told me to get 10% of that money. So for me, because I had watched and studied how Pastor does most of the things. So I just knew that there was a big door that Pastor had opened for me that night. So and I can testify that from that day, which was the 9th of March, things changed in my life. Probably last month when we were fasting in the last week, I got a very big contract from the World Bank. And I'm working on that project. They told me to start work. So even the clients that were not that,
all the clients that I had lost for a long time,
They have started coming back.
In this period, they've started coming back.
What do you do?
I run an advertising agency.
Nina advertising agency.
It's called Fidelity Media Agency. It's called Fidelity Media Agency. Itiwa
Fidelity Media Agency.
So we do 360 advertising strategy.
Tuyambako kulanga ebintu.
Strategy and media buying and like planning for different campaigns.
No planning la campaigns as angel.
Yeah, but I had contracts. I've been running that company from 2014.
Na ina contracts as angel ulokuwa company njito kani zokuwa pili kumi.
By the time I came here, even those companies that I had contracts with, they were not
companies zezo zinalinga nkolela zali zanvako.
So definitely, I just want to encourage everyone who probably is still waiting upon the Lord that he's never too late.
Glory to God.
Give Jesus a mighty clap.
Thank you, brother. The just shall live by faith. Brother, some of the enemies of faith, I'm going to show you. First and foremost, Abraham,
Ibrahim,
according to the other scripture, he did not consider his contradictory circumstances. The first enemy is considering your contradictory circumstances. You want to get married? You consider your age. And you forget what God spoke concerning marriage. Faith comes by hearing. If you read the word of God, what does it say?
Bible says in famine you go satisfied.
What the saint entono mu saturation. Eze zini mu saturation entono. Mwe muri eskendo kumatiza.
Is where the money that will satisfy you is.
Kwanga Bible egama mu njala.
The Bible says in famine.
Enjala teba ya sente zo ya mere yoka.
Famine is not only about food.
Enjala ye mikwano.
Famine for friends.
Enjala ya abantu abeshigwa.
Famine for royal people. You're going to have loyal people in your
life.
When everyone has
left,
God promised to bring you your own.
My people perish because of lack of knowledge. People consider too much. You consider the armies around you. And you say, I am a woman. You consider the bigness of your debt. And you say, I can't pay that. It is beyond my income. Abraham was on like that. For him, he did not consider his contradictory circumstances, but chose to believe God. Chose to believe what came from the mouth of the Lord. Even if you are illiterate, God can do great things for you. Even if you've never traveled, God can use you to build a home. Even if you are ugly, God can bring a husband. Don't consider your age. Don't consider the way you look like. Don't consider where you are. Even if you are far away from the main city, from the capital city, God can still work for you. Don't consider. Many people consider. But David did not consider the bigness of Goliath. He saw a huge being before him, but he remembered the bigness of his God and confronted this being and killed this being. Stop considering. You consider a lot. Look at this situation. abana bakabazayo
children are just back in school
nembereze banange
this situation
lero nadukira wani yani azirina
who has the money now
nogene wono ngatazirina
you try this one
nogene oli ngatazirina
go to the other one they don't
what
have
abantu bonna tebalina
bible
egamba Mordecai agamba
bible says Mordecai says
mtu wadde gwe toikoze esita
that though esita you not done
it do
you have not
neyo bulokozi buna ava walale nyo
but salvation will come for the Jews.
They are not going to perish. You will not perish. Salvation and deliverance will come from another place. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The Bible says in Esther 4:14, for if you remain completely silent at this time, relief and deliverance will arise for the Jews from another place, but you and your father's house will perish. Yet who knows whether you have come to the kingdom for such a time as this. I love that. For such a time as this.
Always seranga chino.
Katonda yetegekera ebiro.
God prepares himself.
Ebiro byolimu mukama yabyetegekera.
He prepared himself for the season you're going through.
It's such a time. For such a time as this.
Kulwechi seranga chino.
That time.
Of
taking your children back to school.
Echo kuzabana bakusomera.
That time when you're getting married.
Echere chongo ugenda kumbiro.
That time when the man breaks your heart.
Echere chongo msaja
kumbiro. There is something.
Walwechi liwo.
Who knows? Whether you have come to the kingdom for such a time as this, I want to let you know, brethren, for such a time as this,
God knew it even before you were born, and he planned and prepared himself. God's knowledge
that comes from him,
he saw that you'd be disappointed, and he put someone aside, and the one that God put aside. If they fail to do it, someone else will come and do it. Salvation will come from elsewhere.
Even if your husband doesn't have a job, salvation will arise for you from another place. Because the Bible says, my people will never be disappointed. My people will never be ashamed, says the Lord. You see the time you are in. According to God's calendar. He saw it. Before you were born. God knew you. God knew your enemies. Knew the job will do. And he
prepared himself for it. He's so ready for it. Amen.
Government is ANC.
International government, states of government.
Ziba ne kitongole kya disaster preparedness.
They have a ministry for disaster preparedness.
Ne government yeguru.
Also the heavenly government.
Na yeri na ministry.
That ministry.
Ya disaster.
For disaster preparedness.
Banga mukama achemanyi.
Because God knows.
Kebizubwe bijja.
The when problems come.
Ya kugamba.
He told you.
The Lord is your strength. Is your refuge and strength. Amen.
Amen.
Your refuge and strength.
When problems come, relief comes from God. You have to run for relief.
Psalm
46 verse 1. And it said
that the Lord is what? Give us the scripture. Hurry up. 46.
God is our refuge and strength.
Yeah.
And a very present help in trouble.
A very present help in trouble. Very present. Very present.
It
is that money. Is it a vow?
That is ever present. Waiting to receive it. Is that money? That God
just
received
it.
My child has not
been.
When they call on
me,
I'll provide. God will give you a ticket. In the name of Jesus. God will give you
a very present help. He's more than ready. Ever ready to save. Ever ready to save. A very present help.
In
times of trouble. God knew that trouble will be in the world. And one day Jesus said, there's trouble
or sorrow in the world. But be strong. For I have overcome the world. What does this mean? I have left. And I've gone to the headquarters. At the command post. This is where I will sit.
Whoever calls upon my name, I will save that person. Whoever calls, I'll tell my father, hurry and save that person. Hurry and give her money. If you get problems, first aid. Genda wa Katonda.
Run to God.
Togenda wa money lender.
Don't run to the money lender.
Togenda wa Momo.
Don't run to Momo.
Momo si joku sortinga.
Momo will not sort you.
Wanyi Elder Julie. Momo.
Momo.
Bamuitani unawama kiziga Momo. Ani gubawa.
Osmosis.
Amugama. Momo joku sortinga.
Momo will sort you out.
Brother. Momo wafiye Yesu.
Our Momo is Jesus.
Yeah, to sorting.
He's the one who sorts us.
Why MTN?
The one for MTN.
He
sorts you, but you'll eventually pay. But our own already paid.
You are not going to pay back.
Togenda kumusa sula.
A very present help. In times of trouble. Why don't you call upon him? Why don't you pray? The reason why you are not praying is you consider a lot. You consider what is around you. Even though
there are 100.
God promised to save you out of them all. Out of them all. Psalm 34:19. He will save you out of them all. Out of them all.
All the have a solution. Every problem has a solution.
Many are the afflictions of the righteous. But the Lord delivers him out of them all. Out of them all. Change the way you see things. Faith comes by hearing. You've heard that God is ever ready. Is present. But if you don't call the police, the police will never come.
Police,
you call the police. Whoever calls upon the name of the Lord will be saved. Why don't you pray? The devil is a liar. Instead of you praying, you call moneylenders.
One day when I was praying, I told God, why are the problems? People are in huge debt.
God
told me clearly, my child, the debt I've not led you into, I'll not bring you out of. That is the last thing I understood. So many people say I hate debts or loans. But there are certain people here that are permitted to go and
take.
And they all come back with one's answer. One woman came and told me, Pastor, I have never serviced a loan. As this one, I have served this time around. How many of you have ever
gone
to inquire before
and
you serviced it with a lot of simplicity without any problem? So you don't run to God first. No wonder they are heavy. Ask God why. And God said it's because I want them to learn through it. Why do you want to learn through a situation? What you have is what saves you.
Why your bicycle?
Offer your bicycle. In exchange for money to go through that phase.
ekiseera kijja
kutuuka
byemuwaayo biweddewo
olwonga
mukola
mukyaokimanyi
nti nekyo ky'owaayo
waliwo
malayika eyakijja ku namulondo n'abonaabonera mu second heaven
ne
bamukuba emigere baprinsipalite b'e Buganda
b'e
Uganda
n'akiisawo
n'akireeta
kimaze
okujja
kali
gw'okiwaayo buwi
kubanga
mbeera
wali
omuyiseeko n'alemererwa
tobeerawo lwakukkiriza okubeerawo olw'okukkiriza tekitegeeza kubeerawo olwa
risikinga
n'okukkiriza bintu bibiri bya njawulo kakati mu kukkiriza
Faith has a background.
Kukiriza or a foundation. Kubako n'omusingi okukiriza.
Faith.
Okukiriza.
You hear.
Owulira.
From God.
Okuva ewa Katonda.
Sikuwulira.
Amen.
With faith you hear from.
Mukukiriza owulira okuva ewa Katonda.
Ekimu ku bintu ebimpanguza.
One of the things that has given me victory.
Sikola kintu nga sose kuwulira.
I don't do anything before I hear it.
Kasampulira.
But once I hear it.
Ebisigalidde twale eri.
Then you take the rest away.
Kasampulira.
Once I hear.
Tujja kuyitawo bojja kuyitamu.
That you're going to make it, it means you're going to make it.
Webiremera awa.
This is where
nga gwachifunye touch believing.
You who has received it if you fail to believe it.
Believing.
Okukiriza.
Is a condition of the heart.
Mbeera ya mutima.
It is the heart which accepts.
Omutima gwe guchiganya.
Mary yali agenda kulemwa okuzaala ekyamagero.
Mary was about to fail to give birth to the miracle.
Yesoka n'abuuza.
Initially she asked.
Kiriba kiti ekyo.
But how will that be?
Nze nga ndi mbeerera.
Because I'm only a virgin.
Nga sikiwulirangako.
And I've never heard of
such. Bajja kunkuba amayinja.
I'll be stoned to death.
Malaika agenda okulaba nga ebitabisobola biddamu.
That he had no answer.
Tatiramu Katonda.
He doesn't respond for.
Ekyo kitiibwa takirina.
He doesn't have.
Y'omulimu ogwe kuweereza.
His own is.
Tasobola kuddamu.
He cannot respond.
Yali atandise okuddayo.
He has started.
Abaakola bwate wawatira abuuke.
Namwe
malindako.
Mary said wait.
Ndi muzaana wa Mukama.
Kibe
ku nze nga bw'ogambye.
Be unto me as you've spoken.
Hallelujah.
Bwate
tomanyi bwe kinaaba.
So you don't know how that
just
would be.
Just accept like a child. Mani bwe kinaaba.
Bukiriza
bukiriza.
Simply believe.
Wotolye towazanga omwana omuto.
If you don't humble yourself like
bukiriza bifeeko.
Forget about faith.
For God is not a son of man to lie.
Kwa Katonda si mwana muto kulimba.
He can't lie.
Tasobola kulimba.
He's not on our levels.
Tali ku madala
gafi.
Kutulimba.
He can't lie.
Tasobola kulimba.
Bwagamba nti n'abaana bo baliyingirizibwa Mukama.
Your children will be taught of the Lord.
Give him a chance. Biveemu bisegulire.
Just give way.
Bisegulire.
Give him room.
Mwagala kubanga uza. Uza ani amumanyi.
You want to be like Uza.
Ani yawulirako ku Uza.
Who has heard of Uza?
Hey, mama nyawo. Temusoma Bible.
They don't read the Bible.
Teri yayawulire ku mutugo bayita Uza.
No one has ever heard about Uza.
Huza.
Huza.
Yani.
Who is that?
Ani yamulira.
Has ever heard about
him? Abero namavundu na bingo.
What does this mean? Namavundu na bingo.
Chitetika.
Chitetika.
Wamulira.
What did you hear about them?
Wanyi. Wanyi tata.
Huza.
Kituwe kakasa.
Musumba yangu huza na
huza. Ule nsobi oswale tukusekerele. Wamulira wa?
Namulira ko musumba.
What did he do?
Yomu.
Is one man.
Kubalenza babiri.
One of the two boys.
Abako atakusanduku ya Mukama ne bafirawo.
And they died at the spot.
Where sanduko ya?
Where was it? Which ark was that?
Sanduko cheki.
Sanduko.
Yali
eva. Yali mwenda gano ya Katonda.
The ark of the covenant of God. Where was it from?
Namugongo.
Sumba binsu se.
Huza.
Huza.
Yayagala okuyamba Katonda.
He wanted to give God a hand.
Sanduke vamba Filisut.
The ark was coming from the
Philistines.
When it nearly slipped.
Namwe mukwatako.
You also want to give a hand.
Toyagala bitera mukama.
You want to surrender to God.
Abaganda basigala bagereza.
The Baganda say.
Katonda yamba ya sunye yambi.
God helps those
Katonda
who
yamba ye yambi.
God helps those who help themselves.
Bobiba byakulema.
If you fail.
Hands up.
Wanike.
Surrender.
Biwe yo wanika.
Surrender.
Kiriza wanika.
Yesu chabaya gala abakoye.
Where Jesus loves those who are tired.
Nemu abata nakowa.
Those of you are not yet tired.
Eno osabye.
You pray.
Eno botagala.
As you try.
Tomanyina mukama wagenda kuyita.
You don't know which way God is going to use.
Yoli.
Are you there?
Praise the Lord.
Amen. I don't know if you understand what I'm saying. Who has understood?
God is a great God.
Katonda yikatonda wa manye nyo.
Totagala.
Please don't be up and about.
Mumbera yonna wali.
In every situation, God is there.
On Friday,
Kulokutano,
under the prophetic anointing,
once we after God,
I declared 10 days
nalangirire nako 10
of what?
Ezachi. Don't you see?
Blessed
are they that hear the word of the Lord and keep it. People don't wait. So it doesn't work for them. 10 days of what? Of eating peanuts?
Of Jesus. 10 days of what?
Eh? Speak louder.
Butafuba.
Of no struggle. But what did it start from? From Mr. Kagame's testimony. I told him, sit. I want to work. I told him, hold on, I'll get back to you.
When he reminded me,
he thought I'd forgotten. I told him, I still know. God had put him into the class of faith. Right then. Deals would come and he would
work.
He took his children back to school. He bought
land.
He bought the deals and bought
the deals.
And he started lending money to those who were working.
God
is so powerful. I said, go and see it. Who has seen something so far? What did you see? Tell us your names and tell us what you've seen. You can come to the front. You are lucky. You have grown up in a generation of faith. Tell us.
Now it dwa Bampita New is Edwin. Najanoksande.
I came here on Sunday.
Najanoksande.
I came here last Sunday.
Musumba Nampita. Nangamba.
And Pastor called me out.
Nwampa dem twa vidi moetan. Ngasiji kolede desi sina chinakola.
I didn't do anything to get that 250,000.
Na naliwaka ku yesterday. Nivankuya wangamba chente zishime.
I got a call to go pick that money.
And
I picked it. So I'm going back to school. When are you going back?
But
I want to thank God.
Mumafuta gano.
Because in this anointing, God has done something for us. With the residues that are left
Yunra weise.
On the street where Yunra has gone.
Ereka yo chibaita road reserve.
It always leaves a road reserve.
Kati nini taka goya sasura.
So,
obutako obusigala yebali.
Any landowner that Yunra has paid, that those are the land left is called
residue.
You cannot buy it. It's so expensive, extremely expensive. Because of the class of the road we are going to get. But I had a need.
Ningamba mukama.
And I said, God,
we don't have time,
money at this time.
But
at least give me someone who can give me this money.
Because
this residue was going to be bought.
And
yet the church would need it. I would like to thank God. Putting my mind aside, my
thoughts,
having been informed reliably, that the owner wants 140 million for that residue.
I
say, God, you have that money. We don't have it right now. But Lord, you have it.
Yori,
are you following?
God
is so
powerful.
God surprised me. So what I did, I invited my fellow ministers. I told the ministers, come, let me tell you this. Pastors, where are you? Sit over there. Praise the Lord. Can I say this again? I'm back. Are you back? Surprisingly, you don't forget such.
You're
following, you're keen to know what's going to happen next. Praise the Lord. After seeing the need, the biggest plot over there, someone can come and put up a storied house because it was 100 by 40. I said to myself, the church needs
it.
But we didn't have the money currently. Remember, we haven't saved this year. We have been using cash to do everything. But it's also
good,
because there are things we can see now. Isn't that so?
Was it saving and is it far?
You can save it and it goes to waste. But at least we have something to show for it. So I told God, I'm lifting up my eyes. We need that plot. I invited fellow ministers. And I said, what can we do now? No one could afford to give us that money. But God is so powerful. God brought someone, one person, who gave me 140 million. After counseling, when I was taking an
loan,
I was invited to the bank to sign for it. I said, what can I do now? I got and went and grabbed the car. I drove like a mad person. I went and signed for it. And they cashed me the money. And now you own a plot over there.
Who,
in this situation, when it is a back to school season, can you ask to give you 140 million?
But with the prophetic, you will never go wrong. I can't tell you, I can't narrate more, but I want to tell you, the church has already acquired another piece of land on the main road, and we are believing God for more, because we are in the season. God told us that this year is the year of reward and promotion. It takes God.
Titwala Katonda.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Enseja kutuke sera ngate cha tutegeera.
Time will come and the world will not understand us.
Buole mu bloko zubuva walala.
If you fail, salvation comes from elsewhere.
Mvude mu banka nga sikikiriza.
When I left the bank, I could hardly understand, believe it.
Nkama feba sibu.
Praise the Lord.
Era tukiriza Katonda.
And we are believing God.
Ofuna amataka amalala.
To acquire more land.
Abraham did not consider. Ibrahim his contradictory circumstances. Some of the things which hinder you from getting, you consider the situation. You go and listen to God. If you can't listen to God, go to men of God. In Israel,
there
were men who are called abalabi.
If you can't see, go to the seer. Let the seer see for you. It is godly.
Chaba katonda.
Let the seer see for you.
Kirizo mulabi akulabire.
Great and mighty things
are
going to happen in this place.
Bigenda kubera mu kifo kino.
It is a big step.
Dala dene nyonyo.
Big, big step.
Dala dene nyonyo.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You may not
believe it, but that's
it.
The time will come
when
our cars are parked all the way from the road to the other side up.
Abraham, the father of faith,
Ibrahim, tata wako kiriza,
did like that. Don't consider your age. Don't consider the generation we are living in.
Mulembe guno gwe tulimu.
Basajja bayayi. Abayayi we bali. Naye Katonda alina be yakweka nga si bayayi. Muleke kudibya Katonda.
Don't strive for the grace of God.
Musumanze byokufumbira.
Pastor, me with marriage.
Basajja bonna bayayi.
All men are crooks.
Ani agamba?
Who told you?
Mubisera bya Sodom.
In the days of Sodom.
Ngabuli muntu aliyebisiyaga.
When people were practicing homosexuality.
Mu nyumba ya Luti mwali mwembelera
bibi. There were two virgins in Lot's house.
Ngateri amanyi.
And no one knew anything about
it. Luti yakweke mbereres.
Lot hid the virgin.
Katona alinagwe yakweka.
Ngatenda
bakubera defiled.
Who has not been defiled.
Wali katona gwe yakukwekera.
Someone that God hid for you.
Abakazi bonna bayayo mulimu abatali
bayayo
Katonda nabe yakweka.
There are some that God has hidden.
Ndi kukulembera.
I'll lead you. I'll go ahead of you.
Nemenya bikomo enzigeze bikomo.
And I'll break the bronze gates.
Nemenya enzigeze byuma.
And I'll break the iron door.
Nekwa bugaga.
And I'll give you riches.
Obwakwekebwa.
That were hidden.
Waliwo bugaga obwakekebwa.
There are riches that were hidden.
Waliwo ebintu ebyakwekebwa.
There are certain things that were hidden.
No one can see them.
Tewali
asobola kubiraba. But they are there for you.
Naye gye biringa bibyo.
For you.
Nga bibyo.
When the time comes, the Lord will go ahead of you.
Mukama ajja kukulembera.
Give you that wealth.
Akwabuga gobo.
I'll go before you.
Ndikulembera.
I make the crooked places straight. I know.
Manyi.
The places are crooked.
Ebife byo tibiterevu.
Crooked.
Bibi.
But when the time comes,
he'll
go before you
and
make the crooked places straight. Crooked mind straight. I'll break the into pieces the gates of bronze and cut the bars of iron. Yes.
I mean,
I'll give you the treasures of darkness and the hidden riches of sacred places that you may know that I, the Lord, who call you by your name, I am the God of Israel. Clap your hands. Stop considering crooked places. Crooked places. Stop considering.
I know you've been robbed and cheated. But the day will come. When God will come. He will straighten the situation.
Where you are a
prostitute.
Where
you shall be respected. Where you are
ashamed.
Is where God shall lift up the standard.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
He did not consider his contradictory circumstances. Stop considering your age. Your place. Amen. This pastor is coming from Musumba. Namaina.
Stop considering that you live in Namaina. Amen. Stop considering.
God can make Namaina a city.
The other words to mean consider.
Consider
to think about, to examine, to observe, to meditate, to reason, considering.
Considering.
You consider a lot.
There are no weddings in my clan. There are no weddings in my family. There is no marriage of weddings in my family. I have 5 children.
Stop considering those children. God will bring a man who says,
your children are mine.
Wanji. Wanji. Esther.
Esther.
Queenie.
Queen.
Wakulira munaku Kadasa.
You grow up in poverty.
Hadasa. Wakulira munaku.
Hadasa, you grow up in poverty.
Singa considering your
looks.
Nebanarulunja baba masaza amalala.
And the beauty queens from all the other provinces.
You
wouldn't have even stood in the competition. You would have told your uncle, don't even disturb
me.
Those people are straight up.
Look at me.
Netunulidanze.
She did not consider her beauty.
Yete yatunulira bulungi we.
She lifted her eyes.
Ne yayimusa amaaso ge.
Unto the Lord.
Eri Katonda.
Your salvation comes from God.
Obulokozibo buva wa Katonda.
Katonda agenda kuyita kumberera.
God will go past that. Will overlook the virgin and
pick you
who has 5 children.
Olokokubemba gegenda okunza abantu.
And you have a thunderous wedding.
Batandike okusala emisango.
Begin to criticize.
Mulogo.
She's a witch.
Ya muloga.
She bewitched them.
Kale kasana muloge dogone likwata.
After all, my
muberawo mudibirawo nze ngenda kola embaga.
I'm going to have a wedding.
Lift your faith.
You must
stop considering.
They care about better no
leader.
The situation is hard up. Yes, it is bad.
You know the devil speaks.
Facts,
but God speaks the truth. Hello.
That's the reason the devil has defeated you, because he tells you the facts. In your family, people are illiterate, and you say that is a fact.
But the truth is not by might, nor by education, but by the Spirit of the Lord.
Satan will tell you.
There
is scarcity of money in the circulation.
That is a fact.
The Bible, but the Bible says in famine you will be satisfied. God knows where he'll get the money from. He knows the ravens. Do you think Elijah? At lunchtime,
he
would the bird carrying a tray with every good stuff.
Bring
it and place it in front of him and fly
you
away.
You can imagine
a
scavenger to bring meat for you.
God is going to use even the unbelievers, the Gentiles. Instead, they'll not touch it. A deal they're interested in, they'll give it to you instead.
Because you belong to God.
I imagine back in those days, people were dying. There was no source of food. God must have sent the raven. It would wait around lunch time. And if you pour the king's food, you'll be beheaded.
New technology of having inside kitchens
they
were trained to carry the food like this. And
kati ngalino kusawa nsinga teise.
He had to put it down
to
consider what just scratched him. And as soon as you put that tray down, it would carry it and take it to Elijah. And then quickly prepare and bring the leftover. Let the king not hear anything about it. And the king always had the second serving. In these days, the kings, they're the ones who have the bigger portion. The raven that is going to
strike
them. Drop the big things and bring them. In famine you shall be
destroyed.
There are kings who have millions. And the raven is
asking for
them. It is going to get to them. The job that was meant for
others. Media ani.
Fidelity Media Group. They'll bring it. They're bringing more and more. They're bringing much more. There are ravens that are bringing it for you.
God will make sure that you don't die with the non-believers. You don't die with non-believers.
There's a raven that is bringing fees. A diversion in the spirit. At this juncture, there are things that are meant to go
elsewhere,
but they are being diverted. Towards you.
Praise the Lord. Anytime God is doing it. She told
her, are you not the one who testified? Tell us. This young lady, she works in Chitezi. She prepares chips. Chips and chicken. The best of the best.
But you know
that chips is
better.
It has a nice aroma. I don't know who knows that. I prefer it. Who says it's true?
Ochitegede.
Do you agree with that? Mr. Buyemba,
Amen.
They're the ones she makes. She spices it with some
oil.
Do they spice it with onion in Mukono? She tests the ones of
Chitezi.
And she fries the chicken. When you get there. You look for her, she's called Juliet. You understand? I had taken a lift and we parked there. And we supported her. We supported her. What did they say that day?
Look at the car that is netuwagira. Now gender yo wagire.
Go and support her as well.
The thing,
those ones of guys, it's nothing.
I
don't know what you're meaning.
Oh man, Juliet chips.
Makes the best chips.
Vuge motoka yo foresta. Ogende chitezo parking. Kula order.
Place your order.
Mwaberandani. Tusobozuereza by DHL.
Send it by DHL.
Soko babulire.
Tell us.
Chicheche abawo
bakakasi.
Abaluganda mukama yebaz.
Praise God, brethren.
Amanyaga ngenze nakalema Juliet.
Nakalema Juliet is my name. I want to thank God that on Friday, after we had left here, after Pastor had released 10 days of
providing,
I got lots of customers more than I've never gotten.
nasanga abana basisedde ebyokulya
webe. I went at 7 at 12 and the girls had really made stuff. The moment I stepped to the table,
genda mpola mpola. Olio manya anyumirwa ate nabidwamu. Aha.
Olwalio yimirira ku meza.
The moment I stepped to the table,
ndoza nafuna ba customer anga basatu benalindudde okufuna.
I got like 3 customers that I never got before.
Ngabuli omwasa baby fibi na bina.
They were all requesting for like 4 pieces of chicken.
Nga yenkoko namba.
Yeah, chali chirudde okubera omusumba ndoza.
That had taken a while.
Nze ngenkoko yange.
Within 1 hour I had sold off all my chicken.
Na yenga abalala bona bajina.
The rest of my neighbors had a chicken. But people came and queued on my table. They could find others standing, but they still
queued.
I served one by one. Yet the rest of my neighbors had chicken. I stood constantly for 1 hour. The moment I sat, I'd sold off everything. What did your neighbors say? My neighbor was just from their village in Busoga. She got so bitter. We are now at
the
with the neighbor. The rest of them are used.
Usimba mamoto kama nini kuka.
Na yo manyi musumba. Omuntu okujja na gamba mpebi fibina.
Nomulala ngatana vao. Before that one leaves, the other comes. It was a long line as if I was serving free chicken. Yet even the people that came before me was...
Kadiulida chino. Bonna botunda nabo kujja konga mulokole mbagobye wao.
I chase out all your neighbors.
Awo fundikira waliwoje. Hallelujah. Kubira Yesu mungano.
Clap for Jesus.
Chiwede.
It is done. How many of you want to test her chips? Raise your hands and I buy for you. Not anymore. Raise your hand.
Don't
tell your husbands to buy for you.
Hallelujah.
She's going to take over that place. And good thing she has
another.
That's how we're going to possess the village.
In
the name of Jesus. Go and buy your neighbor.
In
the name of Jesus. Don't think it's a joke. I have confirmed
it.
It has been entered into the system.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He did not consider. Don't consider the situation.
To considering
ambera. We're
taking children back to school.
To school
does not hinder God from
working. The
fact that you have
people
does not hinder God from
working.
He'll use other
avenues. This is as
you are also
going to God.
That will keep progressing.
That
is called God.
Hello.
Amen. Tell your neighbor that your debts do not hinder God from working.
He will bypass
your debts.
And
he will give you a bed and a
mattress.
He will bypass your debts. And you'll find
chicken
as sweet as Juliet's chicken.
Manji.
Amen.
Remove
your eyes from your problem.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
There is another enemy of faith apart from considering this enemy is putting yourself under the curse by trusting men. In Jeremiah 17:5, the Bible says, cursed is a man who trusts in man.
In such a time as this, don't put yourself under the curse.
That is what the devil wants.
Stand chayagala.
In the beginning, man had no curse. When God created everything, He saw that everything was good and blessed everything. He blessed man. But the devil corrupted man's wisdom. The devil corrupted man's wisdom. Twisted man's wisdom. Because he wanted a curse to alight on man. A curse gives the devil a legal right to do what he wants. Legal right to steal.
When the devil is stealing from a cursed person, he doesn't even run.
Because right.
He feels like he has a legal right on them.
Have you heard? Now there is an automatic curse. When you are praying, never put your eyes or any trust in your husband or in anyone. Put your trust in God. Trust the Lord to bring finances. Don't put your trust in your brothers, sisters.
You've brought a curse on our nation because your trust is in your children who are in Saudi Arabia. You always call them.
Hello, Nankabiru.
Nankabiru, hello. You mean your boss has not yet
been?
Your children are seated, they are not
yet.
Please don't get spoiled. Let me hope you didn't get it and misuse it. We are here waiting for you. You're always checking your
phone.
Nankabiru hasn't sent money through.
You are under a curse. Even if I come with all the anointing, the devil will tell me, this is my territory. Leave me alone. Brethren, trust the Lord. Trust the Lord. Put your trust in God. Those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion. They can't be shaken. People trust in chariots. But for us who trust in the Lord, trust the Lord. Rest your case.
He's
got a chance. He has a mouth to talk. He can talk for you. People don't trust God that He can talk for them. God can talk for you.
When you quiet, He talks.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord spoke to Judah and Israel in the days of Jehoshaphat, the king. The Bible teaches us that God told Jehoshaphat and the entire congregation that you will not need to fight in this battle. They had all the weapons. The armor was full. They had the covenant on their lives. God had told them many things. But see this. The prophet was saying. The prophet was revealing. That there are some battles which can be won without your weapons. And he said in this particular battle, you don't need to fight. But stand still. Then you see the salvation of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Stand still. Stand on the rock. Stand on the word. If God promised you,
He's
not a son of man to lie. If God promised you, He will bring it to pass.
Even if a child spends a month
at home,
rest. Why do you worry? Let them sit. Rest.
abamu temwagala kuwummula
bwemulaba
nga biganyokola
nga
mubibaka nga mubyenyigiramu ne gavumenti bagibanja mama musafiri mpaayo
musafiisaayo
akakadde kamu
bwe
zinambula lina ebitanda byange bibiri ebiliva
omukkiriza
niwe mugamba tuweewola praise the Lord.
Amen.
Atule. Atule.
Let them stay home.
Pastor,
what will people say about
you? They've
already seen a lot, even if you're not
aware.
They know a lot
about
if you. If you knew what
happened to
you, you would even shift from the village. God is still fighting your pride.
Pastor,
how will it even look? Let me tell you. All the time that has been wasted, God shall restore it. There's a woman here who was called Mrs. Wamai. And she used to live in
Kavanyu.
Her husband was Wamai.
Wamai yalina abaana be.
Had his children. But one of his children, a daughter called Nandutu, she used to walk on foot and come here with
a
man from Kabanyolo. They didn't have money.
Mama
her mom told
me,
my child stopped in school. And the others, they completed senior
high.
But
they failed to study.
But please, can you
put that
to complete, at least to get to senior four like
her parents.
And I told her, allow your daughter to serve the
anointing.
Susan would walk from
3 p.m.
By 3 p.m. Previously, we had services daily. She would be here. She would find me here and prepare tea for
me.
One day when she came late, I asked another girl to prepare me. Over there, there was Mujaja. And she prepared the tea.
Take a kamaz.
When she started boiling the water, she picked that Mujaja. Put it and it was boiled. And she gave me herbal medicine instead of tea. I sipped a little bit. I poured out her herbal tea
without Susan
came back. I told her, another cup of tea, please.
Yes, Susan
prepared her tea. The water got boiled and dropped some ginger.
Some
mujaja, when the water was already ready and boiled,
so
I got the aroma that I needed. That's how she used to do it. She spent here a full year. But Susan, one morning, one day dawned. Someone said, I'll take Susan back to school. The Egyptian that we saw,
Susan, we attendika S3.
When Susan started,
she
went and repeated senior 3.
Yes, so
never stopped all the way to the university. When she was about to complete, I gave a promise. Better before you graduate, you will have received a job. And indeed, that's how it was. There was one company of white. I don't know if it was
Busoga.
Bicycles in Busoga. They employed her. Still working there today, and she's a big person. The Egyptian you were seeing, when God takes them away, you will never see them again forever.
Be patient. The Lord knows that the tormentor is still in your house. The tormentor is still on your body. I know that tormentor is, an Egyptian is a tormentor. The Lord is aware that you are passing through what you are passing through. But there is a day. God told Moses,
that
the Egyptian you see,
When I take them out of the
prison,
neither will your children see them
again. The Lord will pay for the wasted years. Wait upon the Lord. Let those
who laugh. That is why you borrow. Sit and let them talk. But when God lifts you, they'll even fail to get what to say. Jesus went through that as well. Used to save others. Save yourself now. How come you on the cross?
You
used to say that you're
perfect.
Prophesy who just hit you.
Yes,
and Jesus was silent. He waited for his time. After he had released his soul, his spirit rather. There was earthquake and a darkness. Thick darkness. People took off. They had never seen darkness during
that.
Surely he was a real son of God. There's a day that
will
when those who are
watching
you,
gamba,
they will
mazima,
say, surely, this one was right.
Mazima,
surely, what they said was wrong. That day exists.
After 3 days,
remember in Akusatu,
they saw
Balaba.
When the Lord was coming out of
Montana,
they went and reported.
And
they gave them a lot of money. Please, the multitudes will stone us. Don't tell them. Don't tell them that the Lord rose. People will stone us. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Why don't you
accept and you be put
to shame?
And then God will lift up the standard. After he was
stripped,
he was clothed with everlasting glory. There's that glory prepared for you. But it comes after the shame. Allow them to say that you're not working. Afterwards, you'll get a job. But the more you pretend around, that's how more God
what
will
are
say.
You defending? Let them laugh. Let them talk. One day, God will lift a standard. God will lift a standard. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You
don't want to be ashamed. Before God comes and shows
up,
let them say what they want. Are you a son of God? Even the thief that was crucified, he also opened his mouth and said, save yourself and save us. Those sheep, God stealers. Bring us and the other
answer,
please remember me when you get to your kingdom. Praise the Lord.
Brother, sister,
who is here today,
don't put yourself under curse by trusting your children.
You'll even cause the death of their jobs because you could even cause that because you're
asking
that you'll buy from
here.
What is it if God brings it through other ways, not through your husband?
What evil is it
if you build your mother a house and it's not your father's
house?
And they material being delivered, and they
put it
within 2 weeks and they roof the house. And they even plaster it. Nakabito, the daughter, has done it. It's a lie. The world does not believe.
Nakabito
is a harlot. That's what they
study.
All jealous people have maligning others. When they
see
anything, anything
better,
that one is a hoe.
Manji, malaya omuyisan.
A ho.
Enkumbi.
A harlot, a prostitute.
Managua, so maybe I won't be malaya.
Mukama feba ziwe.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Baleke bakuite Harold.
Allow them to call you Malaya.
After
Oliver Numa.
The Lord will show them.
Mukama jakubalaga.